So we are talking with Cissy Turnbull, who you are the chairman of the Maryland Democratic Party,
That's right. The
former vice chairman of the Democratic National Committee, and you're the chair of Jewish Women International.
That's right.
So, Cissy Turnbull, welcome. You were at the White House for the first ever Jewish American Heritage Month reception that was given by President Obama and Mrs. Obama. The first ever. Why was that significant? What did that mean to you?
I hadn't really thought about it until I was there and I could see the people who were there. And the people who were there were all experienced or talented in a certain field. There were people there from the arts. There were people there from the humanities. There were people there, journalists and sports figures. And
Sandy Koufax
was definitely the hit. And one of the things that was most interesting about Sandy Koufax was he was it was almost as if there was a glow around him, the way people were responding. Most of the, not only the men in the room, but the women in the room, on behalf of their husbands often, or friends, or sons, or daughters, he is a hometown hero in some respects for so many people.
Absolutely. Of course, one doesn't really think about a glow around a man, but sort of women glow.
But right, but it really was the
case. He has an aura.
He had an aura. And one of the things that someone said, and I think this is really important, is that Sandy Koufax was a fabulous pitcher, but what he is often known for in the Jewish community is making a choice not to pitch on Yom Kippur when it was in the World Series. And he is recognized for that. I don't know if it's on the surface or inside, but people think of him and think of him in such good terms.
Yeah. But my question is, Cissy, what's the significance that this is really the first time that sort of prominent Jewish Americans have been recognized in such a visible way at the White House?
I think it's very interesting. First of all, the Jewish Heritage Month resolution is only a few years old. But President Bush did have the opportunity to do this when it was first passed and made a decision. I don't know if he chose not to, but it just hadn't happened before. So I'm glad that President Obama chose this opportunity. One of the things that they had on display there was they had someone from the Library of Congress who brought the signature of Harry Truman when he signed the declaration recognizing Israel in 60-some years ago. And that meant a lot to people in the room, and people responded to that on being in a historic place in a historic time.
Mm-hmm. Now, some people say that this event is really part of a sort of a series of outreach, part of an outreach to Jews like Elie Wiesel and a number of rabbis to sort of thaw a little bit the relations between the U.S. and Israel, which kind of have had a rocky patch, if you will, since Joe Biden went over to Israel and Netanyahu announced that he was going to be continuing to build in East Jerusalem. And things got a little sticky, but
I don't really think that it did. I think that, in fact, this had been planned. I know that earlier this week there was also an event for Asian Pacific Islander American Month, and I think that that was a distinctive decision that they chose to, during the month of the recognition, to have these events. One of the things that was pretty impressive, too, was that it was people who had done something of significance. There was a young woman I met walking in who wrote a book called Saving Henry. Her name is Lori Strongen. And Lori's book is about scientific achievements that have been taken place when she and her husband knew that their child was going to die. And they learned how to advance science with stem cells and using of stem cells from the umbilical cord. I mean, that's sort of an interesting thing, but it was unusual. You don't usually see someone at the White House. You see more often it's political people, and here there were people, theater people, and people who, journalists, who were there sitting in the audience as participants rather than as reporters. Mm-hmm. And that, to me, was very special.
There's been some sensitivity on the part of Israel or Israeli officials that this administration has been sort of concentrating, or maybe even not concentrating, I should say, on the Israeli-Palestinian problem. They're concerned, the Israeli officials I've heard from are concerned that they're not, this administration is not doing enough about the Iranian problem, because that's really paramount. What do you think?
Well, I think actually the Iranian issue is one that is not only an Israeli issue, but it's an American issue and it's a world issue. Mm-hmm. And I think that's one of the things that we're working on to make sure that that all people understand how critical it is to ensure that for the entire region and for the entire world that Iran does not have a nuclear capability. One of the things that I think this administration is doing is right now there's certainly an effort to ensure a two-state solution so that in fact Israel feels very strongly, and I agree 100% on all of this, that we need to recognize Israel as a Jewish state, that's part of the mandate that's necessary. But there's so much more out there right now under consideration, and I think that the administration has had a great opportunity to move forward. Mm-hmm. And working with hearing a lot of voices, different voices in our community, to solve the issues.
Just a second left in this part of the interview, Susie. Your chair of the Jewish Women International. In a nutshell, what do you do? What is that about?
Jewish Women International is the primary program for women across the world, Jewish women across the world, to promote safe homes, healthy relationships, and strong women. We do a lot in the issues of domestic violence, violence against women. We are advocating for IVAWA, which is the International Violence Against Women Act. We do a lot to help women and engage people in prevention, to have healthy homes and safe families. We do financial literacy training so that women have access to security, economic security. And we teach young people through our curriculums on what makes sense and what you can do and what you shouldn't do in a relationship.